Yes, my mate. Yes. Hey,
you
alright?
Yeah, good.
Good.
Yeah, it's
alright.
Being driven.
Yes, mate. Okay, good. Good to see you, mate.
I don't really look at myself as the big I am. I just see myself as a young, hungry competitor trying to make my way in life through boxing.
Obviously, the boxing world, social media, everybody's talking about a potential fight with Dylan Whyte on December the 12th. Is it just a case of business on Saturday and then get the job done and move on to that fight?
Yeah, most definitely. Just another date. It's been set. I respect Cornish for coming along, getting himself in good nick. And as soon as I move on from that, you know what I mean? I'm not jinxing nothing. I'm not saying too much. But God willing, I move on from that fight Saturday as champion. Me and Dylan will fight December 12th. We've got the British title on the line. He can have his 5 minutes of fame right now. And then I'll move on. And in a couple months, he'll be forgotten about.
When and are you going to stop being fake and be yourself?
And then we'll move on to
the likes of being fake and be yourself? How about that? How about you stop being what people are expecting to be and be yourself? When?
In what sense?
Be yourself. This ain't you. This is not you. I spent time with you before. This is not you. Stop being fake and trying to fool the people. This is not you, mate. Be yourself.
In what sense?
Be yourself. You know what I'm talking about. Be yourself. You come up acting like some good behaving punk. Be yourself, man. What's wrong with you? Listen, you're getting hurt December. I'm telling you now.
Focus,
I'm going
to
mess
Saturday.
You up.
You're lucky to be on my undercard, just focus on Saturday.
Oh, very funny, look at you. I'm not on the undercard because I kicked your ass before. I'm going to do it again, you little punk.
You know what I mean?
Fool.
Just focus on Saturday.
Okay.
You're a fool, bro. Don't talk rubbish, man.
I think...
you're going to get bashed up.
We'll see. We've got a bit of work to do first. And
he's
then,
getting bashed up. I don't care what the wreck. He's getting bashed up. Remember I tell you now, he's getting bashed up.
Okay.
Act like you're this good boy.
We could be back here next week for another press conference.
Go serve up, man, and don't come up here and talk rubbish about being on your undercard.
Right, listen. So, we're going to break now, and we're going to have head-to-heads.
Big fight, December 12th, two heavyweights, Anthony Joshua and Dylan Whyte. How do you see that, man?
I think it's a great fight. I think domestic fight, I think Dylan Whyte, I actually like Dylan. I actually do like him. I know these two have got a little beef. I think Dylan's only mistake would be to judge Anthony on the fighter he boxed in the amateurs.
You know, I've been around and sparred people and done lots of training, so I'm used to different styles, so it doesn't matter to me, you know. Because I've already beaten him, I knocked him down, it's 1-0 to me, and I told him already, just before I came back, I'll be ready for him. Yeah, it is. There's lots of good heavyweights coming up at the moment, some big fights for me especially, you know, so we'll see.
When Dylan Whyte fought Anthony Joshua, I think Anthony was like a 2 or 3 fight novice. He was all over the place. I mean, there's footage of it on the internet. So he's a different animal now. But yeah, they'll definitely be coming up for a strategy because Joshua's a different animal. You know, he's not your average heavyweight prospect. He's getting better and better. And, you know, this is a tough fight for him, but I think he'll shine.
But with Anthony Joshua, full pelt, hungry, young.
Speed as well. Speed kills. And, you know, and that's what I'm talking about people like, you know, Tyson Fury and those kind of fights. That's why I fancy him to beat them kind of people. Because when you're under pressure and you're getting hit powerfully with speed, it's a different ballgame. I know you can counter, but you've got to look to counter. You've got to throw a shot and you've got to not worry about taking one back.
So, to me, it's all irrelevant because fights are fights and they're one in the ring, not at press conferences and not in interviews.
Have you and Dylan spoken, if you don't mind me asking, and me?
The last time we spoke was out in Austria, and that's the last of it. in my life, you've got to remember, when I leave this building, I live my life, you know, family, I've got a life outside of boxing, so Dylan has real no relevance in my lifestyle, really. So if I'm not at, in the same vicinity as him, then I don't have any force or contact with Dylan White.
You've got to understand, and it's very hard, I've been in this situation, it's very hard. If you've sparred with somebody or someone's in your gym and you used to beat him up, or if you boxed on his amateur and you dealt with him easily, it's hard for you to show that respect, it's hard for you to show any fear for that fighter, because you think, I've dealt with you before, I'll deal with you again. Anthony Joshua is a completely different fighter than what he was. He's a completely, he's physically, mentally, emotionally matured. You know, and I think Dylan saw that in Anthony's last fight against Gary Cornish. I thought when he sort of stood there ringside, he thought, wow, this kid's a lot better. I did it when I boxed a guy called Ian Bullock. He was a British title defence. Ian beat me as an amateur. So when it came to the pros, they thought it was a done deal, you know. And then he brought the whole of his town, Bolsover, or wherever he was from, to the fight, and knocked him out in like two or three rounds, one or two rounds, and he couldn't believe it. The club was a different person, and that's the same with Anthony Joshua. I'm not saying it will be the same. What I'm saying is that he's just got to make sure he just wipes the slate clean and looks at Anthony Joshua as somebody who doesn't know. Because that is the guy he's fighting. But I think it's going to be a good scrap. And let's be truthful. On the night, Anthony boxed Gary Cornish, Dylan didn't look that good. He didn't look that good. But let's not judge him on that performance, because he's better than that. So he didn't look that good. But please don't let that fool you, because I think we used to fight on the 12th. Wow, one explosion.
This is the biggest fight in Britain this year, without any shadow of a doubt. We're here today for the first press conference for Bad Intentions, a fight for the vacant British heavyweight title, the Commonwealth heavyweight title, and the WBC International heavyweight title at the sold-out O2 Arena on December the 12th. This is a fight that really has everything. I think it's a fight that has been inevitable for a long time, but it's a fight that needed some stock, and it's a fight that needed some titles, and it's a fight that needed the right timing. Here you have the guys with a huge amount of history, Bad Intentions. Couldn't think of a better title for this fight.
Terrific that Dylan White stepped up to the plate. Anthony Joshua with all the hopes of a nation on him, and Dylan's confident that he can down Joshua and he can be the one to take British heavyweight boxing forward.
He's been out in the Grand Gym in Detroit. He's working with Jonathan Banks. He's deep in the Klitschko camp in Germany right now. And it's a guy that is very, very serious about this fight. And he's a real threat to the gentleman on my right. In my opinion, the future of not just heavyweight boxing, but boxing. But in this division, you're in the ultimate roulette game. You're in a game of risk. Two big men coming head to head. A fight that's built on history and emotion, not just on skill. And that's always a big danger in this fight. Obviously, it's a fight you've wanted for a long time, and your preparation is very, very serious for this fight.
Like Ian Jonathan said, it's probably going to be one of the hardest fights of my career. So that's what we're preparing for. We're preparing for a hard 12-round fight. But I doubt the fight's going to go 12 rounds, to be honest. But, you know, I'm preparing for a hard 12-round fight.
Obviously, since you're fighting the amateurs, you've both gone your separate ways. What gives you the belief, looking at Anthony's progress so far, that this is a fight that you can win at the O2 Arena?
He's somebody who's beaten before. I'm just as powerful as him, if not more powerful. We've both beaten everybody that we fought. We've both improved. I just believe that I've beaten once and I've beaten again. You know, there's not how much he's improved. I know I'm deep in his mind and in his soul, and I'll beat him again on December 4th.
Obviously, there is the history of this fight, and people talk about a chance for you to get even. Is that on the mind, or is it just more about winning the British heavyweight title and another step up the ladder?
Another step up the ladder. British title, especially. No matter if it was Dylan or it was someone else, like I said, I'd approach this with the same hunger, the same attitude I'd approach any one of my fights. This one has a bit more meaning to it, I think, with all of that little trash talking and the attention around the fight. So I think it just gives us that bit more reason to prepare for a 12-round war rather than me going in there. Believing in myself and probably knowing this fight won't. The fights I've been in the past may not go the full distance. This fight has potential to go the full distance. I'm sure Dylan could be the man, potentially, to take me past 3 rounds, but I'll be a real tough fight, it'll be a real tough task for him to do that, because I'm coming, I'll be prepared, I'll be ready. I don't really say much, keep myself to myself, and I think that's why these people think they can beat me, until they get in the ring, and it's quite an imposing figure, you know, when you've got someone who's getting, who's hungry. And I think that when you're about 17, 18 stone, you're rotating from the hips and you're punching with all your might, I think it changes the aspect of the fight. Everything that you believed you thought you could do, I think it changes. So I think that's where some of the fighters have gone wrong. But I don't think that, you know, Dylan's attitude is no different to the last 14 opponents I've had that wanted to come in and beat me. I think they all want to jump on this social high train, become, you know, like get on the sky and start promoting themselves. So it's no different, I don't think. I have to disagree.
Obviously, he'll get a lot of confidence from the amateur belt, of course. Different levels now. I mean, what's different from them? Why shouldn't he take another leap from that belt?
Nothing's different. It's still the same fighters. Still hungry. Still been grafting away for the last 7 years. Same ring. Same men in there. You know, the ring ain't changed. One referee. Just got to go in and give you the best amount of confidence.
And finally, gentlemen, before we post the photos, Dylan, a prediction for the fight. I know some fighters don't make predictions, but there must be a way you see this fight mapping out in your head.
I'm not one of the old men who's fought in his last 14 fights. His average year of opponents been 38 or something, 39 or something. Listen, young, hungry, beaten before. And listen, you know what's going on? If you take a woman for a gym, you did put the first time, she always come back.
AJ, I know that you're not big on predictions either, but there must be a way you see this fight mapping out.
Yeah, I feel like he's saying about 39-year-olds and whatnot. Dylan will step in the ring, I'll get the result, and then it'll be the next man that will try and step up and try to defeat me. So for me, it's hearsay whether I fought 39-year-olds, 12-year-olds, or 25-year-olds.
It's not hearsay, it's fact.
Okay, so that's why you're here now. That's why Dylan's here now, to try and change the course. So once I get past Dylan, I just want to hear what the next person will sit on the table and say. So that's why Dylan's here now, is to give me a young, hungry fighter, put a British title on the line, make it more interesting. But once I get past Dylan, I'll be interested to see what the next man has to say moving forward.
You won't be getting past him, for sure you won't be getting past him.
But that's my prediction, Eddie.
Yeah, that's fine. In between the 6th and the 8th round, you're going to get knocked out.
You're going to leave it that long?
Yeah, I wanted to go long. I heard that he let stuff to be over quick, but why did he go wrong? I heard that he let cookies, I don't really like cookies, so, you know, I like to put my time in and take a bit of time.
Dylan, there was a moment in the press conference earlier where you touched Anthony on the chest and you said, what's your heart beating so fast for? Do you feel like you've got inside his head at today's press conference?
I've been in his head for a long time. It's not today, I've been in his head for a long time. I've been in his head for a long, long time. Since October 2011, I've been in his head. And he's admitted that to me face to face in Austria.
These sparring sessions that you've both sparred Vladimir and you've been in the gym, and you got on well, what went so wrong? It's well documented you don't like each other, but what led to you saying you're a different person, you're fake?
Yeah, because when he was in camp, he acted a certain way. He was like, sorry for the stuff and this, you know. So he acted a certain way. So I was like, that's cool, that's old. And then when I came back, he started talking all his stuff like, he took my kindness a weakness. So I had to go back to how I was with him, you know what I mean? Because I don't be fake. If you don't like me, tell me you don't like me. I'm cool with that. I can work with you if I don't like you. But don't pretend that we're cool and then say stuff behind my back, and then that's just snaky. It's just, you know, that's the sort of stuff scumbags do.
Sitting there as a member of the press, you could have cut that atmosphere of a night.
Especially at the end. I mean, it wasn't. It was better than I was expecting in terms of. The one thing I said to both guys today, listen, we've got a code of conduct to follow, and I think generally they did okay. There were some nice words exchanged, funny at times. When they were having the head to head, it's a little bit. The thing is, with these kind of situations, they can turn like that, and when they turn, it turns at speed, and before you know it, it's all over the place. It's like a tornado. You know what I mean? So I'm glad to get that out of the way. Now we're going to go to Sky for the gloves are off, which, again, you know, that's another hurdle to overcome.
Do you, as a promoter, obviously promoting your brand, does that worry you?
Yeah, it's not just my brand, it's Anthony Joshua as a brand.
Sky.
He won't allow himself, but you know, you've got Dylan's not an idiot at the same time, you know, he knows what he's doing, and also he doesn't want to bring the game into disrepute, but it's personal. Do you know what I mean? It's not just a fight for the British heavyweight title. Although they want to win the titles, it don't really matter. You know, and Anthony can play his PR savvy role, you know, fight, move on, I don't know. This show is called Bad Intentions for a reason. And the reason being is they've both got bad intentions in this fight. They don't just want to win the fight, they want to do much more than that. But you can always take elements of someone away. So Anthony Joshua, he hasn't been PR trained all his life. Do you know what I mean? Before he was even around PR, he wasn't the nicest person in the world. He has spent his life trying to be a good person. But deep down within, he's the person that you don't necessarily want to be around. It's actually the person that comes out when he steps through the ropes. That's what makes him such a great fighter. You can't be a great fighter and just a lovely bloke. You know what I mean? So when you see him come head to head and things get said, that's when the street mentality comes in. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's not, I've been told by this PR guy to say this and say that. It's like, that goes out the window. You're disrespecting me. You're looking me in the eye and that's when, and then all of a sudden, and that's why I'm saying it changes like that. Because no one will allow the other person to take liberties. You know? So you just got to balance it, and it's just, you know, it's interesting to do it because, you know, Anthony says all the right things. And then when they come head to head, I mean, when he said, Dylan said, your heart's beating so fast, they just said, are you joking? Feel it. And then, like, when he put his hand down, I thought, oh, no, please, you know, this is, because it's like, why touch it? And then all of a sudden, so it's good. You know, this is a great fight for British boxing, and we have to keep the code of conduct. We've done it so far, there's a long way to go.
Does it excite you? The last time Anthony fought at the O2, the atmosphere was absolutely electric, and I believe Anthony Gary Cornish.
Yeah.
He lost that fight walking to the ring. Yeah. No matter what Andy's going to do to him, I think that got inside his head and he lost that fight there. Do you think maybe we'll see a similar thing with Dillon?
No, I don't. I don't think Dillon's going to bottle it. I don't think he's going to get nervous. I think the way that Dillon Whyte doesn't win the fight is that he's not good enough. That's the only reason. This is a guy, he's invested in himself. He's gone to the Kronk. He's got Jonathan Banks. He's out with Klitschko. Do you know what I mean? He's not... He ain't here to make up the numbers. He's here to win the fight. If he's not good enough, he won't win the fight. So it doesn't really matter. You know, Dillon Whyte ain't gonna bottle this fight. Dillon Whyte, he ain't gonna walk out and go, oh. He's had that experience. He did it last time, don't forget. He boxed Brian Minto. I know it wasn't main event, but he's still boxing that arena. He still had 16,000 people there taking it all in. So
did a bit of a Sky at ringside as well, didn't he?
He's up for this, don't worry about that.
No, because it's all talk really. So is he. You can't really talk unless I don't see any champions on his resume, so I don't think it's right to talk. You're contradicting yourself, I'd say. So that's why I just had to correct him and just say, well, if that's the case, that's why you're here now. So the next person that comes along will then have to figure something different to say, because it seems to be the same old jargon.